ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯಾದಿಭ್ಯೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯ ಕರ್ತೃಭ್ಯೋ ವಂಶ ಋಷಭ್ಯೋ ಮಹದ್ಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ಗುರುಭ್ಯಃ ಸರ್ವೋಪಪ್ಲವರಹಿತ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಘನ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಗರ್ಥೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಸೋಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ. ಓಂ ಪ್ರಪನ್ನ ಪಾರಿಜಾತಾಯ ತೋತ್ರ ವೇತ್ರೈಕ ಪಾಣಯೇ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಮುದ್ರಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ಗೀತಾಮೃತ ದುಹೇ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶಾಯ. ಮೈ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಶಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪರಿಪೂರ್ಣ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದಂ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ವ್ಯೂವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್ವರ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಚಾನಲ್. ಮೇ ದ ಆಲ್ ಮೈಟಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್ವರ ಬೆಸ್ಟು ಆಲ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಸ್ಪರಿಟಿ, ಹೆಲ್ತ್, ವೆಲ್ತ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಟರ್ನಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಕಟಾಕ್ಷಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತಾ ವರ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 5 ಆಫ್ 6th ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್. ಶ್ರೀ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಉವಾಚ ಉದ್ಧರೆದಾತ್ಮನಾತ್ಮಾನಂ ನಾತ್ಮಾನಮವಸಾದಯೇತ ಆತ್ಮೈವ ಹ್ಯಾತ್ಮನೋ ಬಂಧುಃ ಆತ್ಮೈವ ರಿಪುರಾತ್ಮನಃ. ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿಗೇನ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್. How healthy we are, in order to find that, we need to have a measurement. Is there any measurement other than blood test, other than scanning or MRI, CT? Regularly we are undergoing blood test and this all MRI, scan and everything. But there is a simple technique. You measure your sleep. If you get a proper sleep means not oversleep or not less sleep, and it has to be a deep sleep. So this is the measurement. If you are getting proper sleep every day, then that is the symptoms that you are a healthy person. And to have a proper sleep, we have to work properly in the daytime. In order to sleep is the actionless state. Sleep occupies us. We are not making effort. You know, if anybody says that I tried half an hour, 1 hour to sleep, he was not trying. The trying when it ended, okay, that effort when it ended, he dropped, then he could have slept, otherwise not. So that's the fundamental formula. Meditation, as I told you, is a process, but the benefit, what we call it, the meditation, that will take place its own. Now Bhagavan Krishna began. There are two kinds of sadhanas for the meditation. Two kinds of steps for preparations. One step known as Bahiranga Sadhanani. Another step called Antaranga Sadhanani. Bahiranga Sadhanani means the first preliminary preparations for meditation. What are the preliminary preparations? The first with our transaction. When we transact with the world, that transaction gets a kind of impact outside. The same way, also we get impact inside. When I wish somebody, you know, wish you a very happy new year, then that wish even makes some impact inside. The mind and body and buddhi, it has got the tendency. What is the nature of these three aspects is, so it has to be taken care very carefully because it's very vulnerable. We have to be aware about it. We cannot sleep well after punishing somebody. We cannot sleep well after scolding at somebody. If at all you are sleeping well, you have to be either jnani or you have to be somebody who is extraordinary. I think you might be understanding what I indicate. You might be extraordinary means beyond human being something. So human mind has kind of nature of the mirror. What you want to show to others, you will see that. And what you see in others, that will be shown to you. Therefore, it's a two-way coin, two-way corner. You have to be very careful. What you give, you gain. What you make the impact outside, that impact will also made be inside. Therefore, we have to be with a very careful handling in our transaction. When we speak to others, when we look at others, when we do something with as the gesture with others, we have to be very careful. And when we get the thought also, we have to select the thoughts to be engaged with that. It makes the impact. When you see a child, you become like a child. You talk to her, you talk to him. So when you talk to him, you make a kind of playful, joyful actions towards him. But the same thing, when you talk to a matured person, you transfer yourself as though serious person. If the person is lovable to you, you transfer as the positive energy. If a person is beyond your wishes and beyond your nature, I'm using the beyond. I don't want to use the negative words. So negative words, you know, against. So when you are not able to reach anybody, I call it beyond. Nobody can be against you unless you make wrongdoing. Then you will be the first person who can be against you. Therefore, the transaction makes impact inside. Whatever that impact you want to give out, it will be made inside. So that you have to careful. You have to be careful. That's what the message from Krishna. So he taught how to maintain our mind during the transaction with samatvam. The person who is contained with samatvam, he will be called yoga rudha. This yoga rudha is the state where you know how to transact with the world. Bhagavan Krishna doesn't say that go and sit immediately directly for the meditation. That sitting for the meditation also has got lots of norms in it. How to sit, where to sit, when to sit, and where to not sit. All these are called bahiranga sadhanani. Sadhana means the preliminary preparations for the meditation. Now we saw in the last session how to become sarva sankalpa sannyasi, inner sannyasa. So who could be away from all the sankalpa, we saw elaborately, then he will be called yoga rudha. That is the first state. Then second step, he is going to tell that self effort must be proper. So what are the self effort? Now we can call it bahiranga sadhanani. There are two kinds. So one is samanya sadhanani, another is known as vishesha sadhanani. So samanya sadhanani are called two kinds. So one for samatva, another for self efforts. That self effort has to be adopted. In other words, the technical term for that is will. We call it free will. So will means a determination. When you make a will, so willfully you make something what you want, isn't it? So if I want to achieve a very healthy body, then I should will for it. That's what we call it. Will means, sometimes we also mean it as a proper decision with the determination. When you dedicate for that, it's known as a willful actions. Now we are going to understand what is will, free will. Free will means, so human being, we can use our decision making power. We have the space, that space known as కర్తుం వా అకర్తుం వా అన్యథా వా కర్తుం. యు క్యాన్ మేక్ అ డిసిషన్ టు గో ఫర్దర్ ఇన్ టు ఎనీ ఫీల్డ్. యు క్యాన్ ఆల్సో మేక్ ద డిసిషన్ నాట్ టు గో, నాట్ టు ఎంటర్, ఆర్ యు క్యాన్ మేక్ ఎనీ డిసిషన్ టు గెట్ ఇట్ డన్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ వే. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, నౌ యు వాంట్ టు గో టు ద టెంపుల్. Somebody is calling you, so please come. You know, this month is a glorious period for going to the temple. Then immediately you can deny it, you can go along with him, or you can say that let us go in the evening. So that also you can say. So you can either go along with any decision, you can change the decision, or you can make the decision not to do. That's what the capacity which we have called free will. That free will makes everything. Now you may have the questions. So every jiva has got free will. What about the fate? You know, these people who believe in fate, I suppose we call it a fatalist. So those people say everything is because of fate. If everything is because of fate, we need not to work. That's what the question from other people. Now, there are two kinds of things. Both of them are introduced by our Shastra. Vidhi, Mati. So, Mati is willfully we use free will to make the decision. So, every second we have to utilize that free will. So, when you get up, I will get up by 4:30 in the morning. It's a willful decision. So you can also change it. But when you keep the alarm, you made the decision, you keep the alarm. When alarm rings in the morning, that time, if you have again free will to get up, to not get up, or you can also get up a little bit later, that free will is utilized in every single second of our life. But we have to know how to use it, when to use it, what to use it. That free will makes life. This is from the modern people. They say that only free will is the life. No. Shastra balances in between. So there cannot be complete life which is oriented with only free will. There are not completely life which is oriented with fate. So everything is fate. The Shastra says we do have prarabdha, sanchita, even agami. Prarabdha means, so when we were born, at that time itself we have been born with certain karma phalas. It has to or had to, will have to fructify the fruit. Okay, whether you deny or not, you will be driven to experience the fruit. That's what prarabdha is. Thus prarabdha, so simply if you want to get a sweet by 10 o'clock, then you make also a decision, I won't eat the sweet. If somebody is bringing the sweet, that's your prarabdha, that sweet is coming in front of you to give certain experience of eating sweets. Okay. Now you have the free will to choose the prarabdha or not. Now the experience is ready to, or it's served in the plate. Now you can make the decision whether you eat or not. That's what prarabdha vashat. According to our prarabdha, the result of past action, every experience are provided, we have the free will to deny or accept or modify it. But there are prarabdha, we call it very strong prarabdha. So those prarabdhas cannot be changed. You know, that prarabdha is very strong, more than your capacity, your free will sometimes won't work. That time we have to be with prayer. Like you made some program, you are going to arrange, you have been organizing that program, you fix the date, and on that particular day, heavy rain happens. We call it prabala prarabdham. This prabala prarabdham is more powerful than your decision, your free will. At that time you have to accept. And there are prarabdha, so we call it madhyama prarabdha. Sometimes you make or you organize some program, some hurdles, obstructions are coming, so you can use your free will to remove them or to neutralize them, or vaidika margena or laukika margena. So whatever the way, so as through spiritual marga, as through normal way of transaction, you can remove. For example, if you want to open the shop, that chief guest is not arrived at. So you can make somebody else as the chief guest, you can open your shop. That's what, you know, obstructions may come. If the obstructions can be neutralized or can be switched over, that we call it madhyama prarabdha. Durbala prarabdha even is very less. So easily you can overcome by making your free will, by making decision through your free will. Therefore, here, when you want to get growth in the spiritual path, you have the obstructions. Those obstructions may be prabala prarabdha or madhyama prarabdha or durbala prarabdha. In fact, we are living with our prarabdha karma phala. The Shastra is very careful in order to specify this ideology, but this is not ideology, it's a fact. You transact with you, means your karma phala alone, whatever the experience comes, that's because of prarabdha. Those experience may be changed by your free will. Sometimes prarabdha is more powerful than your free will. Sometimes you can also balance. That's what the life. Therefore, you know, you cannot omit the vidhi. You cannot also completely utilize the mati. Both has to be supported by Ishvara's grace. Therefore, we stick with Ishvara's grace. At the same time, we also don't lose to make effort. We also don't miss to make effort. Our effort is very important role to play in the spiritual growth. I have seen many people who started meditating, who started studying the scriptures. After 6 months or 1 year, they leave. And they will do something else, they will start and they were not able to continue that also. That's what the self-effort has to be, lagatar, continuously to get it done. In order to sit for the meditation, you have to work properly, you should be healthy and you should be also calm, peaceful, and you have to be also concentrated. So all together called Yoga Rudha. That's what Bhagavan Krishna has given. Now, in these words, he says, so you can be your enemy, you can be your best friend. The enemies are not outside, the enemies are inside, not even inside. Your own body, mind and sense complex can take as the role of enemy. That depends on you. That's a kind of trick, that teaching from Krishna. Now, first he begins positively. Uddhared Atmana Atmanam. Atma means here we need not to take a pure consciousness. Atma means he mentions, he indicates the body, mind and sense complex. You have to grow. You have to rise yourself with yourself. Atmanam na avasadayet. You don't demote yourself. You need not to, because your activity, your free will, your decision makes your life and it also destroys your life. Therefore, you have to be careful enough to make the decision, make the action, deliver the action. That's what he mentions. Then, in the next verse he says, how can one be enemy to himself? And how can he also become friend to himself? Let us read it. Bandhur atma atmanastasya yenatmaivatmanajitaha anatmanastu satrutve vartaitatmaiva shatruvat. Yena atmaiva atmanajitaha tasya atmanaha bandhuhu. Who has got mastery on his sense organs and mind and buddhi, he becomes for him. So this all body mind sense complex is bandhuhu. It's a different way of approaching the problems which we face. We think always the problems are coming from outside, isn't it? If somebody is scolding us, immediately we become irritated, restless, and we are not able to sleep. Whatever that happens outside, first we lose our sleep. Spiritual says, don't lose your sleep. Okay, so when you lose your sleep, you will lose peaceful mind in the daytime. When you lose the peaceful temperament in the daytime, you will lose the result. You will lose the result means what? You will lose the delivery, the actions properly. Then you will or you won't get proper result. It's everything is connected, you know. When you make a proper action, you will get the proper result. When you get the proper result, that again you will get the ability to make the proper actions. When you want to work properly, you should have slept properly. So when you want to sleep properly, you have to work properly. That's what the nature of our system. Now he says, you have to make your bandhu, you can become friend to you by overcoming, by having proper control on your system. Anatmanastu shatrutve vartet atmaiva shatruvat. So don't make your system as enemy to yourself, then you can destroy yourself. Nobody can destroy from outside, only one person can destroy you, that is you. It's a big understanding a meditator should have. Then he will become very careful with his actions, with his thoughts, with his body, mind and sense complex. Therefore, the first transaction was given. The self-effort has to be proper. That self-effort is called Uddharet Atmana Atmanam. That's what he made the quote or quotation. You have to raise yourself by having proper control on your sense organs, on your mind, on your buddhi. Means when you make the decision, you have to make the proper decision. That's what he says. When you make yourself with positive instrument means for meditation, jitat manah prashantasya paramatma samahitaha shitoshna sukhadukhesho tathamana pamanayoho. When you have the mastery over your systems, you can maintain the peaceful state before meditation itself. That's what we needed. Before sitting the meditation, you might have been organized by the first two steps. So first with the samatvam and the second one is self-effort. So these two are known as bahya sadhanani. So these bahya sadhanani, the instrument in the transaction or with the transaction will make us vyavaharika shanti or vyavaharika shantaha. When it means vyavaharika shanta means you become very peaceful when you transact. That will give a kind of condition inside which will help you to sit for the meditation. We will continue from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.